A geologist working somewhere in remote Siberia drilled a hole 14.4 kilometers deep, roughly 9 miles. When the drill bit suddenly began to rotate wildly, the project manager was quoted as saying they decided that the center of the Earth was hollow. The geologists then measured temperatures over 2,000 degrees inside of the hole. Then they lowered a super sensitive microphone down to the bottom of the well, and to their astonishment, they heard the sounds of thousands, perhaps millions, of suffering souls screaming. Hey everyone, welcome to After Dark Analysis. Today we're going to be talking about what hell sounds like. As with most urban legends, there is a grain of truth in this story. This is an embellishment of an incident that happened in 1984. An article appeared in Scientific America about an experimental well in Russia. The well went 12 kilometers down, not the 14.4 claimed in the story. In this hole, they encountered rare rock formations, water, and flows of gas. Not the screaming souls of the damned. The temperature inside the well also read as 180 degrees, which is nowhere near 2,000 degrees. It's hot, but not that damn hot. This legend first began to circulate around the internet in 1995. It seems the source it was derived from was a 1989 broadcast by the Trinity Broadcasting Network, which is a religious network based in the US. It seems that they picked up the story from a Finnish Christian newspaper that was published in July of 1989. The source is also referenced in an article from February of 1990 in an issue of Praise the Lord magazine. The article was translated over from the original Finnish source and even stated, "Scientists are afraid they have opened the gates to hell." Since this was an insane news story in the 90s, the Weekly World News had to get involved. Except for in their version, it was set in Alaska, where 13 miners were killed after Satan came roaring up from hell. And for those of you that like to look at the sources, the link to the Weekly World News article is dated 2008, but I'm fairly certain that's when it was digitized and not when it was actually written. And since we're on the topic of Weekly World News, there was yet another variant to the story saying that a bat-like creature was found inside of the well. Even though that wasn't the version published in the Weekly World News, it seems like a bit of a missed opportunity. What really got this legend traction is it started to come back around with an attached sound clip, supposedly of what the researchers heard. YouTuber Moscow Jade was able to figure out that not only was it total bunk, but the sound clip comes from the 1972 film Barren Blood. Radio talk show host Rich Bueller set out to track down the origins of the legend himself. He published his findings in July 16th of 1999 in an issue of Christianity Today. He found that the original Finnish article did not come from a respected scientific journal, as some were claiming. In fact, it was a newsletter published by some missionaries. From there, he was able to trace it back to an incredibly vague claim that it came from a Christian newsletter in California. From that, he was able to figure out that the Trinity Broadcasting Network had gotten a supposed translation of this story by a man from near Oslo who had visited California. This man was a school teacher, but apparently also a bit of a troll. When the radio host called for more information, the man confessed that after hearing the story about the screams coming from a deep well while he was visiting California, he simply clipped a Norwegian newspaper article on a completely unrelated topic and made up a translation to see if he could fool anyone. Since this legend is on the newer side, it doesn't have much representation in pop culture, sans the 2009 film 9 Miles Down, which is obviously in reference to the depth of the hole. The film opens on a completely trashed dig site, writing all over the walls in blood, got a coyote on the floor, in some kind of ceremonial circle, because of course it is. The bulk of the film revolves around Jack and Kat trying to piece together what exactly happened here. Kat believes science makes life more magical. Jack believes it makes it less magical. They end up getting together. One of the issues, though, is Jack's wife committed the sin of suicide. Anytime it looks like Jack and Kat are going to have any kind of romantic interaction, Jack immediately has a flash of his dead wife. As we've talked about in the past, yes, horror has some very puritanical views in regards to human relationships, but since this film has a religious bend to it, it's a little bit more pronounced. But the entire story devolves into, is Jack insane? Does Kat even exist? And if Kat does exist, is she Satan or some kind of demon? A lot of this film's runtime is devoted to Jack going deeper and deeper into insanity and him trying to cling to either religion or science or some amalgamation of the two to explain what's going on and what's happening to him. This film chose to focus a lot more on the religious implications of if scientists actually had dug a well,
down to hell.
And what that would mean for everybody. So to say the least, there weren't a whole lot of concrete conclusions as to what was actually going on. Unlike the story it's based on, which has been debunked time and time again. Thank you for listening. I'd like to take a moment out to thank my patrons, Scotty Robot, Carla Hoffman, Gani. If you'd like to contribute to this channel financially, there's one tier, it's $1. You get a thank you in each video and Discord access. Even if you don't contribute to this channel financially, your time and viewership is always appreciated. Thank you.